because of everyone here, that they met, and that they're here at this point in their life. This time, Mr. Mettert, Caleb's father, is going to have our opening prayer.
Truly, Lord, we are thankful that we've been here this day and recognize. Truly, Lord, we are thankful that we've been come here this day and recognize the union between Shoseana and Caleb. Lord, we ask that you help to bless this union and that you bless their marriage. And that you guide their steps throughout their life, that they may realize their own needs. We ask that you continue to watch over them and guide them to God. We ask all of this.
Amen.
Fourscore and 7 years ago, wrong speech again. Caleb asked me about courting Shoseana. I gave him a word of encouragement and caution. Told him that she's very stubborn. She's the most stubborn daughter that I've ever had, the most stubborn child. But I can be a blessing. I told him that as well. When I it can be a real blessing. It took me a long time to realize that with Shoseana. When she was very young and a toddler, I read books and I prayed, and I just didn't know how I was going to get through to this cute little curly-headed girl. And it finally hit me one day, and I thought, if I could ever get her stubbornness turned in the right direction to where she wants to do what's right, there's no end to where she can go. And God gave me peace with that stubbornness. 1 Corinthians 13, verse 8 says, love never fails. Shoseana's stubbornness is going to come in real handy. It's never going to fail. When I was investigating Caleb, what dads are supposed to do, a lot of his friends that knew him from a young man growing up said the same thing about him. Said as just a very little guy, he would bring in something and take it apart and sit there for hours and hours and hours working until he figured out how it worked, how to take it apart, how to put it back together, how to fix it if it came to him broken. And he showed that same determination in his life. That determination and stubbornness for you guys is going to be a blessing for to tie each of you together in a long, happy marriage. Prince Philip once said, when a man opens the door for a woman, it's either a new car or a new wife. Well, this is a funny saying, don't let it be the future. I've watched Caleb do many gentlemanly things for Shoseana. And Sean, looking after him, doing womanly things for him. One writer said the difference between an ordinary marriage and an extraordinary one is giving just a little extra every day as often as possible for as long as we both live. Shakespeare said, love looks not with the eyes, but with the mind. The Bible says that first, God looketh on the outward appearance, or on the inward, on the heart, but man looks on the outward appearance. Don't get caught up in looking at on the outward at things. Always strive to look at the heart, and like God does for us. Love at first sight is easy to understand. It's when two people have been looking at each other for a lifetime that it becomes a true miracle. Some interesting things with Caleb and Shoseana. I talked to them about their courtship. They told me that Caleb logged 280 hours driving back in the midst of their courtship. And since they began courting, right with Him and keep right with each other. Working on the ambulance, I often get people, older people that have been married for 50 to 75 years. And I always ask them, what's their secret to a long, happy marriage? And the thing that I've found is, there is no secret. It's just doing kind things for each other, doing a little extra, and treating people like God wants us to treat each other. First Peter 3:7 says, likewise ye husbands, dwell with them according to knowledge, giving honor unto the wife as unto the weaker vessel, and as being heirs together of the grace of life, that your prayers be not hindered. Very important part in there. God is going to hear our prayers and answer our prayers, but that's going to be in importance with how we dwell together as family and as spouses. The excitement of new love comes and goes. Storms will come, and that stubbornness will rise. But always look and remember the person that was perfect, because they're the same person, they still are. Ephesians 5:33 says, the wife should respect her and reverence her husband. He will make mistakes, but always respect him and his position in your home and life. In Ephesians chapter 5, it says, giving thanks always for all things unto God and the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ. We often read the Bible, don't read everything in context. Sometimes we pick on one thing or another, sometimes we pick out verses that might help someone else. But I found the more that I read and understand for myself, the more of a blessing that God's Word is to me. Submitting yourselves one to another in the fear of God. Wives, submit unto your husbands as unto the Lord. The husband is head of the wife, even as Christ is the head of the church. He is the Savior of the body. What a big task it is for a young man to be the Savior of his wife. Therefore, as the church is subject unto Christ, so let the wives be to their own husbands in everything. Husbands, love your wives, even as Christ has loved the church and gave himself for it. There's no greater sacrifice than to give your life for someone. And Christ gave his life for his church, for his bride, that it might sanctify and cleanse it, that he might sanctify and cleanse it with the washing of water and by the word, that he might present to himself a glorious church, not having spot or wrinkle or any such thing, but that it should be holy and without blemish. So ought men to love their own wives as their own bodies. He that loveth his wife loveth himself. For no man hath yet ever hated his own flesh, but nourisheth and cherisheth it, even as the Lord, the church. For we are members of his body, and of his flesh, and of his bones. For this cause shall a man leave his father and mother, and shall be joined unto his wife, and they shall be one flesh. This is a great mystery that I speak concerning Christ in the church. Nevertheless, let every one of you in particular so love his wife, even as himself. And the wife see that she reverence her husband. Read and memorize this passage. God's word for a family. Always looking at our duty and never at the other person's duty. Always look for the blessing in your marriage. Winston Churchill said once, my most brilliant achievement was my ability to be able to persuade my wife to marry me. But it goes both ways. Your marriage Marriage is a gift from God. Always cherish it. Never take it for granted. Martin Luther wrote, there is no more lovely, friendly, and charming relationship, communion, or comfort than a good marriage. We're going to have a poem. Favorite quote that I've found in preparing this message is, a good marriage is like farming. You have to start over every morning. Start over every day with God and let Him guide you forward. Now we're going to have a blessing prayer for the bride and groom. Tempest happened in their life. It's always every day and draw closer to you and closer to each other. Your name, amen. Amen. Caleb and Shoseana have chosen to write their own vows. I'm going to recite them to each other now. In the presence of God and these witnesses, do you vow that you take this man to be your lawful wedded husband? To live together in holy matrimony, to give love and respect and obey him, sickness and health, for richer, for poor, and forsaking all others, keep thee only unto him as long as you both shall live. Caleb and Shoseana have decided to show the joining of their two families by the lighting of the unity candle. Thank you. Thursday.